Now, all revved up for more Red Hot Motorsport, it's the LG Super Racing Weekend with
Yokohama, power of performance.
Welcome to Pergusa in Sicily, where we've witnessed one of the best super racing weekends this season. High speed near oval, proving just as challenging as expected. Track temperatures exceeding 40 Celsius in qualifying and giving way to colder weather for race day. 3 hours of racing ahead of the field and 35,000 fans here to see the action. Fabrizio Gollin will lead off the big boys, having beaten Mike Hazeman's Super Bowl challenge by 0.7 seconds. And Anthony Garcia set pole in the NGT class, his Porsche 996 GTR moving from fourth place in qualifying with a shootout time 0.1 second faster than Christian Pescatore in his JMB Racing Ferrari 360. So the championship looks like this, with David Terry and Christophe Bouchot on 44 points apiece. Now, poor old Bouchot missed out on the Super Pole. He was carrying 100 kilos of penalty weight, that is, mainly because he did so well in Spa. So the GT teams look like this, with Larry Competition of France on 60.5 ahead of Lister Storm Racing on 49 points. Lister Storm, well, they're back in the groove after doing so well early on in the season, having something of a tail off, shall we say. NGT driver Stefan Ortelli, busy man, taking part in Porsche Super Cup Racing Weekend, the special at Spa after winning in Spa, and just seems to be wiping the floor with everybody at the moment. Ortelli and Mark Lieb will be partnering him today in Free Second Motorsport, JMB Racing, ahead of Tricinger Motorsport at the top of the NGT class. Let's speak to Fabrizio Gullan.
Sorry,
your first pole coming through on the Super Bowl.
There we go.
Well, firstly, we just want to finish this race. That's the main thing. Very sober. And we were in a good position. Not really thinking about victory just for the time being, because it's a very long race, 3 hours in all. And so we just got to stay focused. Well, a particular strategy, tyres, what? Well, no particular strategy, he says. And for sure, we will be trying to avoid punctures on a difficult surface. The track, though, he says, is very, very dirty. It most certainly is. Then getting set to get started. And around they go for the warm-up lap. Yeah, the Lister Storms, early dominance of the Lister Storms, fading by their own standards mid-season, due notably to the rise of the Ferrari 550 Maranellos. Jamie Campbell-Walter proving, though, that the Listers are not just sprint cars. As for the Maranellos, well, three consecutive wins pushed Jean-Denis Delatras and Andrea Piccini to the top of the class at Oschersleben. But then, of course, came the Vipers. Dominant performance in Spa, topping off a great run in the GTSRs. Let's take a look at the track that is ahead of us here. 4.95 kilometers in all, a near oval around the basin of a blown away volcano, thankfully dormant. Well, they put in a couple of chicanes just to make things a little bit safer. It's long though, almost as long as Silverstone. So, brisk winds, thankfully not producing the predicted dust storm from the dried-up lake in the centre of the course. That's because we've been blessed with some drizzle. Blessing, well, who knows, the surface is not as stable as many might expect. Combine that with the high-speed nature of Pergusa, and you'll understand why it's been so dramatic here. 35,000 fans, then some live on the edge of the crater here. The rest have kind of snuck in, shall we say. So, a look at row one. It's the Chrysler Vipers 1 and 2 with the Ferrari 550 of Calderi and Brinner ahead of Jamie Calmer-Walter and Springer's teammates in the Lister Storm there on row 2. Well, a great effort by the Lister Storm, really proving that the balance is absolutely spot on, and if the surface does get a little bit unstable, then you can expect them to come through. Leading off, the NGTs. That'll be the team of Garcia and Velvermeyer. ahead of Pescatore and Bertolini and Dowdy and Sauvage. So coming around to get us started then at what will be 3 hours of racing before the flag falls on the lead car. Stefan Ortelli and Mark Lieb in the Porsche, the Freisinger motorsport car. And they've got the points lead, as you've seen, and even found time to enjoy winning the Porsche Super Cup event in Spa, one of their favourites. Well, there's been a lot of talk about cars and balance, and everything was thrown in the bin, it seemed, in Spa, in all classes and all categories on the Super Racing weekend. And they say it could be exactly the same here at Pergusa. A difficult track at the best of times, notoriously difficult to overtake, and with a packed field like this and a mixed field, as you well know, in FIA GT, then traffic always a problem. And just look at the amount of debris that is on this track. Bumping and bruising there has been throughout qualifying, and splinters and shards there are by the looks of things from earlier accidents. The field's coming round then, and a treat in store, you can be sure. Christophe Boucher, we were on board with him just a moment ago, carrying that 100 kilo penalty after doing so well in Spa. And almost a disincentive, isn't it, to do well, having to carry those that extra weight. Lamborghini just coming through there of Gavin and Clerico, and the 360 Molina of Pescatore and Bertolini racing in the NGT class. Whole hat full of Porsches. Ferrari out to spoil their party in the NGT class. Ferrari, of course, also represented in the top table. Round for a rolling start then. Here we go, about to go racing. We've got the green flag and it's clean away for the Vipers. Very short run in to a difficult combination here. And let's just keep our fingers crossed for the rest of the field as they come through. Remember, it's 3 hours. Nobody should be pushing it too hard just yet. So racing away from under the beautiful villas that overlook this track, and Jerry Cavalwalter already having a look here. Doesn't like that fourth spot, thinks it could be a third. And as you can see, just coming off the combination there, dragging dust onto the track. And as the tyres warm up, and through comes the Lister Storm into third place. Great move by Cavalwalter. Out front, the four car of Capillari and Fabrizio Gullin. Well, a lovely start early on for the Lister Storm, and proving that its balance is absolutely spot on. Front engine Vipers, well, a lot of development has gone on so far this season, and they are taking something of a quantum leap. They just seem to be getting better and better with every race. Now, the broader cars may have some difficulty going through the chicane, and already problems. Well, well, well. The 17 machine already bitten the dust. Felbermeyer and Cassetti. No full course yellow. Plenty of room to get there, or time indeed, to get that car off. It'll just be a local yellow as they continue racing here. And the Lister really looking very good, taking off a different angle here. Is he going for second place? Down side by side. It looks like it could well be set up perfectly for the combination as we come to them now. No, too wide. Can he hold it for the exit? No, he can't. Far too slim coming into the S's. Vipers one and two. The Listers looking very good though. So tight and compact this field. Gavin leading Hazelmans, Cavalwalter, Brinner, Babini and Deschabord. Their confirmation of the times. Oh, and look at that debris thrown up. So much littering the track here, and there'll be an awful lot more, you can be absolutely certain, before the end of this. Those cars get damaged. Those shards of carbon fibre just lying around, and they can cause all sorts of problems, particularly for the tyres. And this track, oh, look down, and the Ferrari's on the move. On board with Hazemans, the number three. Blasting by him, he's down a spot. Through the combination. Well, just having a look on as Calderari and Gounon's machine gets itself up into third spot indeed. Well, lovely to see such a mix out front. It's normally one car dominant and others following. The Vipers not having things all their own way, despite leading here. Great to see. Round once again, Fabrizio Golan. Well, Campbell Walter has done a great job here. Hazelman's, his challenge, fading in fourth. I think I wrongly predicted he was in second place still. Of course, he was battered past. And lovely to see. Time difference there. Brunner, well, starting to drift and will be coming into the clutches of Hazelman's. For the time being, though, things starting to settle out, the field starting to stretch a little wider, and you can expect things to settle into something of a comfort zone here, and it'll be a blessed relief to those just off the podium spots, where it really has been something of a challenge. Let's just leave it at that, shall we? Golin leading, Campbell Walter, Brunner, Hazemans, Derishborg, and Babini. Seventh lap of what is likely to be around the 100 mark, provided everything continues apace just like this, and breathing down the neck of the leader is Campbell Walter. Hazemans is back in third place. Gola just keeping it very, very steady indeed. We're just having a word with Luca Vicitelli about his problems earlier on. He said, we suddenly lost power, the engine seems okay. We just don't know where the problem comes from. We're just checking at the moment. Well, cars in difficulty on the track, as you can see, and the toll is starting. Lights on from the Lister, just letting him know that he's there and he's going to have a challenge. And local yellow flag once again. Jolin in the Viper, followed by Campbell Walter. Looking a familiar sight now, and a real battle this between these two, and thrilling this crowd of 35,000 that's turned up here. Well, it is possible to get some slipstreaming, but you're going to have to be a good deal closer than that, Jamie. Through they come, the combination. He's closing. Colin, Campbell Walter and Hazemans, but just look at the gap now that's starting to open up. These two, they may be battling, but they're not slowing at all. Hazemans in third on the Viper. Fischberg, Babini, Vernon Rose in the other Lister. He's in sixth place. Bouchou moving through with his 100 kilo penalty. Really doing well to pick his way up and move on. And starting to get into traffic, it's the delight of GT racing, of course. Don't want to harry the slower cars. That can incur a penalty, as you all know. Gola being gentlemanly. Hazemans and cleanly through the pair of them. Well, the listeners were so absolutely outstanding in the first part of the season, and then started to fade mid-season as those Ferraris came into their own. But the balance of the car has been absolutely outstanding, and particularly suited to this track, it seems. They're certainly up there challenging. The Vipers not really getting the run that they want just to pull away. The listeners sticking with them. Very difficult course this, particularly hard on the brakes. It was a very, very fast course before they put in the little chicanes, but it was a dangerous one as well, and an awful lot of drivers didn't like it, particularly those racing open wheel. Just said it was just too risky. Well, a beautiful setting it most certainly is here in Sicily, and as far as this form of racing is concerned, you couldn't ask for a better setting. The crowds have turned out to prove just how popular it is. Any form of racing, of course, naturally. Very popular in Italy. Well, the F550 coming through. Not posing the nearest of challenges to the leaders. The 550 Maranellos. Well, three consecutive wins it was that pushed Jean-Denis Delatraz and Andrea Puccini to the top of the class. That was after Oschersleben. But then, of course, the Vipers just started to get into gear. The Ferraris currently third in the rankings. The Vipers' dominant performance in Spa, just topping off a great run for them. So, yellows still out. Carefully warning all and sundry. The leaders, well, still stuck together. Well, the wind's blowing something of a gale. Thankfully, reasonably well protected here because of the high walls of the old volcano. Difficult to predict, though. If there was a wind sock, it'd be blowing all over the place as it eddies and blows, but not too strong. A brisk breeze, but certainly not hampering them, it seems. Over the line once again. Well, Golan really did the business when it came to qualify, and indeed the Super Pole, just holding off all challenges. In fact, in the GT class, it was only positions 5 and 6 that were to change, with De Richebourg leapfrogging Fabio Barbini. Jerry Cavalwalter really is starting to get close here. 0.422 of a second, and you can see he fancies it. I look one way. Probably just setting his man up psychologically for later on in the race. Passing opportunity in the combination there, though, that we've seen. It done. Very, very tight, isn't it, through this little combination here. On board with Hasemans, and our slick little LG camera showing action elsewhere on the circuit. Three car of Mike Hasemans trying to run down the leaders now. Up into third place. Oh dear, oh dear. And an interesting section to get stuck. Just bedded deep in the gravel there. Merendino and Merendini. Well, just ruining their luck, presumably. Golin still holding off the attentions of Cavalwalter. Hasemans starting to close, and he'll be getting in the mix very, very shortly. Derek Bort, 4.461 seconds down, and then the gap really does start to open up after Babini. Vernon Rowe 13.274 in the other Lister. Nice to see him still in touch. Clara Cup, three cars further down in the Lamborghini. And the safety car called out, and hardly surprising, that 60 car, that Porsche we saw stuck in the gravel, really was in a very dangerous position. Surprising it didn't come out even earlier. We'll be back with more after this short break. Stay with us. Welcome back to Enna Pergusa, and Campbell Walter is under great pressure here. Hazeman's right on his backside as we go green here, lap 17, and he's through. Trying to get the switch back, but it looks like he's in the wrong place for the combination, and Jamie Campbell-Walter is down into third place, having another crack here down on the inside. Whoa, that was very, very close indeed. Well, a shame to see the Lister dropping a spot. It's been battling away majestically there, but Hazeman's really was on the metal at the restart there, and it's Vipers 1 and 2. And indeed, as you look back beyond the Lister, four of them there in the top five. Well, the second Lister machine also in close attendance, just behind the 550. And the Vipers starting to flex their muscles here. Well, those tyre barriers protecting that little chicane there and forcing the cars to go through instead of just chopping and going straight on. They really have taken a hammering here, both in practice and qualifying, and a lot of frontal damage there was. An awful lot of severe wear on the brakes as well. And you can see that we've got a little bit of dust, but you can hear the pitter-patter of rain. Is that on the mics? Maybe it was just applause. Over the line again. And the four car of Fabrizio Golin just absolutely in a class of its own, it seems. Very, very well balanced and just carving its way through the entire circuit here. Well, biding his time, Campbell Walter will be girding himself for another attack, but for now, six or seven car lengths between himself and the man who's just moved past him. Well, track temperatures during qualifying were around 41 Celsius. So very, very different to today. And the crowd, if you look, very, very wrapped up indeed. Mind you, Italians will wrap up in the middle of an English summer, but nonetheless, a little bit nippy, certainly, compared to yesterday, and autumn most definitely is approaching in Italy, as Jamie Campbell-Walter just really nails it coming through that little combination there. A lot of oil dry on the track, as you've seen. And some of the black skid marks masked as well. We don't need too much of the kitty litting, because the gravel is plentiful around the track here. The cars do take the course very wide indeed, as you can see, and carving a great stretch of rubber there, the fourth place car. Viper teammates coming through, cars four and three. So starting order on the grid has been found once again. A shame to see that the Ferrari 550 is just seemingly getting left behind here and will soon fall into the clutches of the second Viper. Oh dear, that looked reasonably heavy, and he's going to have to be careful he doesn't get a puncture there. The bodywork looks like it's very, very tight, against the wheel there. 77 off the track. Russians running in sixth place in NGT. Number 77 car of Femiko and Vasiliev getting some attention. And this was the moment that they did it. Well, just how wide do you have to go? Raid rallying, it certainly looks like, and they're lucky not to lose the front lip there. Heavy bump. So let's take a look at the NGT class, as we've been ignoring them for quite a while. And we're on board with Lieb, not Ortelli here, as the little computer is showing. He leads ahead of his teammate, Dodi. And the first Ferrari, number 51. Montemini, stretching his legs. And the 50 car, Pescatari, don't forget they split their team to pose more of a challenge. Yes, Christian Pescatori, GMB Racing team leaders, teammate Andrea Montemini, split for this race. Pescatori is in the 50 car with Bertolini, and Montemini is riding with Iraj in the 51 car. Distinctive black Lamborghini of Garavin and Clerica, 31 machine as we look further back, and a beautiful sight. GT fields, so many different cars, different classes, all mixed together. Purest form of racing for many people. Clock rolling down, of course, and it's the lifeblood of Le Mans and other great championships, and some of the best looking vehicles in competition taking part. Wonderful. Montemini coming through. Teammates locked together. Here's the Ferrari 360Ms. Really have started to elbow their way past the Porsches. Lap 27, Golam still leading in front of Hazeman's Campbell Walter. Well, he wants to be careful that that rear screen from the three car doesn't interfere. Well, as you can see, that rear screen quickly attended to. Duct tape, very handy device. So the pits strategies starting to come into play. Time to change. Well, a real problem, a real sad thing indeed for the three car. And just look how heavy those brakes have been working. Smoking away, nothing wrong with that. As soon as they get moving again though, they will be much better cooled. Well, Fabrizio Golin saying, moment, everything is that we thought before the race is starting to come true. I really hope that Luca Capellari will maintain a good position. And me, well, for the last hour, I'm just going to attack to the maximum, he says. So, lap 35, and we've already seen the four car in the pits, and in comes the leading Lister. It's Springer coming in to replace Campbell Walter, and a very, very accomplished outfit this. Say that they managed to run on what is the budget for catering for other teams, and they've really have blessed us with some fantastic racing over the last few years, and they're not finished yet by a long chalk. The Lister Storms are right back in and proving that they can be on the metal, on the carbon fibre, whenever required. After 40 laps, a little confused, the leaderboards, as we are starting to filter through the pit stops, Babini leading Springer for the time being. But this will all change as they all come in for their pit stops. Expect to see the number 4 Viper and the number 14 Lister at the top of the list when we come back. Laps deep in here at Pergusa, and once again the Listers facing a hefty challenge from the free car of Viper. Kumpen on board and jinking down inside. Nicholas Springer is taken over from Jamie Campbell Walter. Well, Dewis still leading, but plenty of changes have been, and indeed more to take place. And the three car, just look how quickly he left the Lister behind that. Well, a couple of changes because of those pit stops. Dewis leading Springer, Kumpen. Puccini in the mix as well, as is Capellari and De Castro. This is looking tasty. And the 23 machine really does fancy their chances here. The Ferraris coming into their own later on here. Well, perhaps on a different fuel loading, Delatras and Puccini really have clawed their way back up through the field. Starting on row 9, they really are bombing along, currently in third place ahead of Springer. Dewis leading Hazemans for the time being, but I can't see that lasting terribly long, as Dewis will have to come in. 54 lap mark then. So coming to what many regard as the halfway point then here. Lap 57. Well, Kumpen took the lead just a few moments ago in the three car, ahead of Dewis on board the 12 and the 23 machine of Delatraz. Now you may be wondering why the number 9, the Ferrari, just had such a desperate time of qualifying. Well, they had air intake difficulties, and indeed it just put paid more or less to their qualification results. There's the 550M, the airbox just all over the place, and it wasn't a case of not conforming, it just was deformed apparently, and giving them all sorts of trouble. Well, Kumpen in the pits, fuel and tyres, and the drive passes over to Hazemans. Dewis leading Delatraz, Springer in that third place, but 32 seconds down. Ortelli just in a class of his own, it seems. Loved it at Spa. Loved it so much he stayed and took part in the Porsche Super Cup, which he then went on to win as well, along with Mark Lieb here. And Mark Lieb accomplished as well in the Carrera Cup, and indeed a whole host of other German series. Lap 64. Duis and Delatraz. This the battle for the lead. Oh, had a look. Door was shut in front of him. Delatraz coming through, and his airbox problems, I think, in the past, as he just gets a little bit dirty, and all of a sudden he just starts to fade there. Snicked he was. Mark Duis then back at the head, and the Ferrari just backing off there, and had to. He's challenging again though, coming down here on the long straight, braking very late. So strong the Ferraris in terms of braking. Through the combination and away. Leaders coming into the pits. 23 car out in front. Hazeman's then. It is, I have to inform you, it's leading ahead of Campbell Walter and Piccini. Lap 80, and things started to warm up considerably. Cars really getting a measure of each other. Hazeman's still leading Campbell Walter, Piccini, Babini, Golan, and Ortelli. And that just shows you, if you push it a little bit too hard here with so much debris around, you're going to lose it. Well, it was more hope, wasn't it, than skill. And I have to say that I feel extremely sorry for the guy who's going to have to rebuild that Ferrari. Certainly not his fault, but Diaz was really gunning for it and took his man out. Kumpen on 82 laps. Ahead of Campbell Walter and Babini, Colin, Duisberg and Ortelli. One lap down, but phenomenal performance by the man in the lower class, the NGT. Whoa! Well, all on his own there. Well, just getting back into this one, and quite obviously damaged from the incident earlier. And the 23 car is all but wrecked. Look at that. And once again, spinning off into a relatively safe zone, thank goodness. That'll be a local yellow, but an awful lot of damage and indeed debris on the track. Andrea Piccini, not a happy man. Hazeman's leading Campbell Walter, Babini, Golan and Derichborg. And a stop and go penalty for Babini, and hardly surprising as he's effectively ended Ferrari's challenge. Let's speak to Piccini. Well, I have to see it on television what happened exactly. What I know is that Babini put me off on the second chicane, to say the least. Missed the corner before it directly hit me. I think 20 or second stop-go penalty is just not enough for what he's done to us, he says. And effectively, he destabilised the car. And that was the result. Dias decided to restart. The suspension, he says, had failed. And that's when we crashed heavily. Well, it was as we said, the incident just a little bit earlier had caused all the problems, and the car, well, just not stable enough to continue. More in a moment. Clock winding down, we've got around 10 laps remaining here. On lap 90, Hatemans is still out in the lead. We're on board with him as we look further back at some action. But Jamie Campbell-Walter it is that's taken over the Lister. And he, the nearest man to it, Hazeman's really pushing it, trying to put as much distance as he possibly can be between himself and his challenger. And it's a goodly distance, I can tell you. Hazeman's coming in for a splash and dash pit stop. Well, we said splash and dash, but he's got a problem. And he can't restart the car. Well, it just caught then, but everyone's foxed. Once again, it turns over. Well, this is an absolute catastrophe for Mike Hazeman's. Once again, it spurts, but it's just not rolling. There we go. Nope, down again. Finally underway, and they tried to put some more fuel in. It's a fuel line problem, we think.
The car was very good, and first in Mike had a puncture, and then now in the end we came in for a splash and dash because of the puncture we had in the beginning. So and the car wouldn't start. Apparently there's something wrong with the fuel system, and we don't know what.
Co-driver Anthony Kumpen there. And it means that Jamie Campbell-Walter and the Lister crew are out in front. And if a look at the time confirms things, around five laps to go. Campbell-Walter now leads Golau. Ortelli, leading the NGT class, is eighth overall. On board with Andrea Bertolini, fourth in the NGT class behind the Freisinger Porsche. And indeed the Ferrari, number 51. Montemini. Well, the weather that had threatened a little bit of rain. We've got clear blue skies, and it's blue skies all the way as far as Jamie Campbell-Walter is concerned, and it seems Ortelli. Cyril Sauvage, second of NGT, ninth in the overall classification. They really are competitive, these cars. Maybe a class below, but the driving like equals here. Cyril Sauvage coming through. Been a very clean day for him. His car looks like it's fresh out of the box. On board with the 50 car of Bertolini, 11th overall, fourth in the NGT class. And just holding his own. Nursing his baby home, and why not? And you can see the splashes of rain, just as we were saying, the blue skies are here, starting to burst on the windscreen. And he daren't put the wiper on because it'll just smear up, and so close to the three-hour mark, he really doesn't want to throw anything away. So he'll live with that rain. Flipped his visor up as visibility starts to wear, and just look at the little baubles around the track. Irach Alexander in the Ferrari 360, one of the split cars. Yes, he racing with Montemini. And on board with Hazeman's. What desperate luck for Mike Hazeman's. Fuel line problem, it seems. A mystery indeed. Could be anything. Could even just be a little speck of dirt in the line there that just held things up. But certainly, it was the end of his challenge. This is the man who's leading. Jamie Campbell-Walter. And the Lister Storm boys will be absolutely ecstatic. Well, they'll be very pensive for the time being, I can tell you, but waiting to celebrate, and it really has been a wonderful ride for them. The car, perfect balance, it seems, just absolutely beautifully suited to this track, and while others have had their ill fortune, it's certainly not all down to luck that they're where they are. A great outfit, run on a relative shoestring, doing Britain proud. Look at this. just wants to avoid getting into a tangle here unnecessarily. And Jamie will just carry this one gently through. Not going to be too bothered about the other car from another class. And the team just waiting to start grinning. Always pensive moments, these. Time's out. We're heading round for the checkered flag. And it looks like a little bit of damage to the undertray there. Hardly surprising after riding the curbs all afternoon here. Pergusa is very, very rough on the machinery. And the robust nature of the Lister has come through. Celebrations for the Lister boys. They've earned it. Fantastic day's racing. Campbell Walter and Springer, our congratulations going out to them. Wonderful scene, kisses all round, and relief indeed. Well, challenging when they needed to, being measured when required. But the endurance, well, they just held on, didn't they? Beautifully, and just drove away with it. Checkered flag for Ortelli, taking the NGT class, the German flag out, and we salute him as well. Jamie Campbell Walter, Nicholas Springer, they're bringing the Lister Storm in. 3 hours, 14 seconds. Galigna and Cavalieri, second place, and the number 12 Viper in third. Vipers, 4, 5, and 6. Bouchot finishing in fifth place and carrying that 100 kilos like a man. Bobby Vernon Rowe and Miguel de Castro bringing the other Lister Storm home in seventh place. Highly creditable. And then Stefan Ortelli and Mark Lieb leading in the NGT class. And some of the larger class cars finishing behind them as well. Let's have a word with Jamie Campbell Walter.
It was a hot fight with car number 3 and 4.
Yeah, it was a, you know, I think it's an unexpected win for us after the Haseman's car's pace in the qualifying, but for some reason we were able to lap at the same speed as them in the race, so they lost some of their advantage somewhere, and the car held up wonderfully considering how hard it is on the circuit. And you know, we've had a win and we're back in the hunt. We're only 4 points behind Bouchou now, and it's really good. And congratulations to everyone involved, Dunlop, the Lister team, and Nick, of course.
And how was the race for you, Nick?
It was good. You know, I had to go as fast as I can and stay out of trouble. That was my mission for today.
Thanks.
Okay, and thanks for everybody. Yeah.
Well, Stefan Ortelli also sparing us a word. He says, I really want to first of all thank the team for Porsche for all the efforts that they've done for us. And of course, Mark Lieb was his third race. Thanks a lot, mate.
I'm sorry, your impression about the race?
Oh yeah, it was very good. So we had a really good start at the beginning. The Ferraris put a lot of pressure on us, but we really could keep up with them. And we had a really good strategy. The team worked very well together the whole weekend. And thank you to Stefan, he did a great job and everything is very, very good. I'm so happy.
So a look at the top of the Drivers' Championship with Terrier and Bouchou on 46 points and very, very close behind, as you saw, the Lister boys. Yes, Lister Storm Racing emerging victorious here at Pergusa. Third win of the season for Jamie Campbell-Walter and Nicholas Springer. And it's done all sorts of great things for Lister Storm Racing. Look at that, 59 points behind Lambrate Competition of France on 62.5. Next round is at Donington on October the 5th. We look forward to your company for that. And don't forget Super Racing Weekend Magazine coming up this Wednesday. That'll be at 7 p.m. Central European time, 6 in the early evening in the UK. We've had some fantastic racing here in Pergusa. a delightful spot in Sicily. If ever you're in the area, drop along, open your wallet, and have a go at this circuit. The Lister boys did, they loved it. So the next Super Racing weekend, round 9, Donington Park, October 5th and 6th. Martin Haven will be there to carry you through. From me, Carlton Kirby, thanks for your company here in Pergusa. It really has been one entertaining weekend of bumper-to-bumper racing. Thrilling stuff, seen live and highlights here on Eurosport. From Pergusa then, in Italy, it's bye-bye.
With LG Electronics, digitally yours. That was the LG Super Racing Weekend with
Yokohama, power of performance.